The lower limb has four muscle types, gluteal, thigh, leg, and foot, which for the thigh and the leg in two compartments are put. Know that leg muscles are divided into compartments three, anterior, lateral, and posterior, as you can see. Anterior, medial, posterior compartments are in the thighs, secured by the fascia lata, a sheath which compression applies. The iliotibial tract is also known as the IT band, a longitudinal thickening of the fascia lata, understand. Gluteal muscles move the femur, deep ones do lateral rotation, while superficial muscles do abduction and extension. The superficial muscles include the tensor, fascia lata, oh my, and the maximus, medius, minimus, which are the three glutei. The largest, most superficial gluteal muscle, gluteus maximus, forms the buttocks, prominence, over which we make a fuss. It's the thigh's main extensor, and with lateral rotation assists. The IT band strengthened by gluteus maximus fibers, it enlists. Gluteus, medius, minimus, abduct, medially rotate the lower limb. Secure the pelvis while walking to stop pelvic drop of the opposite limb. Tensor fascia lata, superficial, makes the fascia lata taut. So abduction, medial rotation on the lower limb is brought. Deep gluteal muscles make the femur laterally rotate. Pull femoral head to acetabulum, so the hip joint stable mate. They include piriformis and obturator internus, superior, inferior, gamuli, and quadratus femoris. The piriformis is most superior, laterally rotates the hip. This flat muscle also causes abduction of the hip. Obturator internus and gamuli are called triceps coxae by some. They act on the hip, perform abduction, lateral rotation as one. Now we come to quadratus femoris, which is flat and square. This deep gluteal muscle does lateral rotation, be aware. The thigh's anterior compartment has three muscles to discuss: quadriceps, femoris, sartorius, and pectineus. Near iliac, psoas, which consists of psoas major, iliacus, which converge on a tendon and flex the hip joint thus. These four muscles form the thigh's bulk as quadriceps femoris, vastus lateralis, intermedius medialis, rectus femoris. To the patella via the quadriceps tendon they unite and attach, by the patellar ligament to the tibia the patella then dislatch. Know that quadriceps femoris is the main knee extensor, vastus muscles are also a patella stabilizer. Rectus femoris extends the knee, flexes the thigh at the hip. It crosses both the hip and knee joint, such a long trip. The sartorius, the body's longest muscle, is a knee flexor. It's a hip flexor, abductor, lateral rotator. Pectineus adducts and flexes the hip joint, and there's disagreement on whether it's in the interior or medial thigh compartment. The thigh's medial compartment has gracilis, obturator, externus, adductor brevis, adductor longus, adductor magnus. Functionally, the adductor magnus can be split in two, with adductor and hamstring components, which we'll now review. Know the adductor component adducts and flexes the thigh. Meanwhile, the hamstrings component adducts and extends the thigh. Adductor longus is on top of adductor brevis, which is shorter. This large flat muscle adducts the thigh when given the order. Obturator externus adducts laterally rotates the thigh. C. Gracilis crosses hip and knee joints, adducts the thigh, flexes the knee. Now the thigh's posterior compartment, the hamstrings, let's discuss. These include biceps femoris, semitendinosus, semimembranosus. Biceps femoris has heads short and long, which share a common tendency. It flexes the knee, extends the hip, laterally rotates the hip and knee. Semitendinosus, semimembranosus, extend the hip, flex the knee. And the semitendinosus is over top, as you see.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out all of our other anatomy songs.